I'm Dr. B. Ravi Kumar, Associate Professor, Department of ECE. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss about combinational logic circuits in which adder, subtractors, and comparator. So far, we have discussed about digital electronics in which Boolean algebra and Boolean theorems and then logic gates and a definition of functions in SOP or POS and canonical and standard forms, and then how to draw the simple Boolean functions in a logic diagram and how to simplify the Boolean functions. So these are we have discussed in previous lectures. Those basics which will be useful while designing combinational or sequential circuits. Let us see what is combinational circuit and how those fundamentals will help to design the examples of combinational logic circuits. We know that basically any digital circuits, either it is in combinational or sequential. The definition of combinational circuits are circuits whose present output depends upon present input only. In contrast, in sequential circuits, the present output depends upon present input and also previous input, like a previous output also. So in this combinational logic circuits, there will be no feedback from output to input. N number of input variables are given to combinational logic circuits, and N or M number of output variables in the combinational logic circuits. Basically, in digital circuits, it is made up of with some blocks. In order to perform some operations in the digital circuits, like arithmetic and logical operations, it needs to design those corresponding circuits. In our digital circuits, the first one is arithmetic operations. In order to perform arithmetic operations, it is required to design arithmetic circuits, arithmetic logic gates. So what are those arithmetic logic circuits, like arithmetic additions, adder, subtractor, comparator, okay, and multiplier and division, divider. We can use those kind of operations in digital computers. Let us see now first adders. What is adder and how many types of adders which are used in digital computers, and then how to design those arithmetic operations like adder. So by following this procedure, for any combinational circuits, when we follow these six steps, we can easily implement. So these are the important steps. Let us see one by one those steps. The first one is problem is stated, problem is defined. Define the problem. Whatever the problem from the user end, the user requirements, we need to be stated. We need to be defined those problem, identify those problem. And then once stated those problem, the second step is define how many number of inputs are required, how many number of outputs are required. The identification of or defining of these input and outputs, where output variables, is only done by knowing those problems stated. Once defining those input and output variables, then assigning the letters, English letters, for those input and output variables, because these variables can be helpful to defining the functions, Boolean functions. Once defining the letters, then derive the truth table, creating the truth table. The truth table that defines the required relationships between input and outputs, which is derived. And in this table, basically input columns and output columns. Output columns may be one or more. Sometimes it requires one output column in the truth table, sometimes more than one output columns. The next step is the simplified Boolean function for each output is obtained. Whatever the output in the truth table, each output column need to be simplified with the help of theorems, with the help of Karnaugh theorem. We have already studied theorems, Boolean theorems. It is somewhat difficult to apply. So that's why we go for a Karnaugh map. By using Karnaugh map, we can, minimize the Boolean functions, minimized into minimum number of literals. And then next, draw the logic diagram for its corresponding minimized Boolean function. These six steps will help to design any combinational circuit, any new combinational circuits, whatever the user requirements, whatever the user asked us, we can design by following these steps. By simply, as simple of adder and understanding those adders and apply these steps. Let us see one by one first. Now, what is adder? Adder in the digital computer actually basically perform the basic arithmetic operations is the addition of two binary digits. Now, there are different kinds of adders, a simple half adder and a full adder. Half adder is a combinational circuit which performs the addition of two bits is called half adder. Suppose if it performs the 3-bit, then it is called full adder. Half adder is performed on 2 bits, full adder is performed on 2 bits and one bit from least significant bit forward carry. If you want to add any 2-4-bit number, that 2-bit addition will get summoned carry, that carry forward to the next MSB bit, that will be treated as 3rd bit. So in full adder we can perform 3-bit addition. So now let us see how to implement this half adder and full adder by following those design steps. So now we see now half adder. What does it mean half adder? It performs the addition of 2 bits only. What are the possibilities of adding of two bits? This kind of possibilities may be a 0 plus 0. If you add arithmetic operations for the logic value, you will get 0, and 0 plus 1 you will get 1, and 1 plus 0 will get 1, and 1 plus 1 the logical operation of plus symbol, 1 plus 1, 1 only, logical operation. Arithmetic operation is different, 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So this kind of 2-bit operations performed in this half adder. Sometimes it may require, for example, if you want to add a 0, 1, 0, B, 1, 0, 0. So in this case, if you add, start from LSB to MSB, 0 plus 0, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1. In this way, we can perform the addition. But in digital computer, how can it perform? With the help of logic gates. Okay, that is what we want to design. That is what user requirement. User requirement is addition of 2 bits. This is 1 bit, this is another bit. If you want to add those 2 bits, we can use half adder. How can we design? How can we implement a logic circuit which perform the addition of these 2 bits? Okay, let us see now. First point is define the problem. Define the problem. Addition of two binary digits is the user requirements and define it's a problem stated. And then second one is, if you add these two bits, so you will get, suppose if you add these two numbers, 1 plus 1, you will get sum, like, you know, in addition, sorry, here it is, actual is 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0, and this is arithmetic, it's not logical operation. So here 1 plus 1 means 1, 0, where 0 means sum, and this extra bit is carry, you can call it as carry. So in order to represent that extra bit also, we require two inputs, and already we are giving two binary digits, binary numbers, so it requires two input. So second point, defining input and output variables, how many number of inputs are required, how many number of outputs are required. In the off adder, we require two bits. So in order to perform this is the off adder. A, B are the inputs, or XY are the inputs. XY are the inputs. Sum and carry are the outputs. So defining the input and output variables, X and Y are the inputs. Sum and carry are the outputs. Sum and carry can also be represented. We can also represent with the S and C. So assigning the letters, English letters and like variable names to those input and outputs. X and Y are the inputs, and sum and carry are the outputs. These are the three steps. Next, fourth step, defining the truth table, make the truth table for those off adder. Truth table have basically two columns, input and output columns. The input columns based on the number of inputs, if it is a two variables in the problem. So there are two possibilities in the input columns. If it is n variable input, 2 power n possibilities represented in the input column. In this input side, in the table, X and Y are the input in the off adder, sum and carry in the output. So X and Y means 2 variables, means 4 possibilities, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. What if inputs are 0 and 0 to the off adder? Your result, sum is 0 and carry is 0. And what if x 0, y 1? 0 plus 1. Off adder adds 2 bit. 0 plus 1. Sum 1, carry 0. And 1 plus 0. Sum 1, carry 0. And 1 plus 1. In this case, we can add 1 plus 1 means 1, 0, 0 sum, carry 1. 1 plus 1, 1, 0, sum 0, carry extra bit, carry. Once creating the, defining the truth table, with the help of direct inspection from the truth table, if it is truth table, is very simple. Directly we can write down the boolean function, otherwise we can go with the Karnaugh map. So actually I'll go with this first simple inspection and then inspection method and then go with the Karnaugh map. If you see direct inspection, sum, where is the logic high in the sum output in this case and in this case? So the output should be include these corresponding minterms. Its corresponding minterms are 0, 1 and 1, 0. Considering those minterms, we can get S is equal to the output logic 1 for 0, 1 combination means 0 means uncomplemented variable, 1 means uncomplemented, 0, 1 means x bar y plus and also another logic high, output logic high for another input combination is 1, 0, x and y bar, x, y bar. So that is directly we can write down the boolean function. And carry, this only one logic 1 in the output column, which combination logic 1 is that x, C is equal to X, Y. In this way, we can write x bar y x plus y bar. Suppose if they came, if it is table is truth table is a more number like 3 variable, 4 variable, we can apply the Kirchhoff K-map. So in this case, if you apply the K-map for sum, if it is 2 variable means only 4 square boxes, 1 in x variable, y direction in the y variable, x is equal 0 row, x is equal 1 row, y is equal 0 row, y is equal 1 row. We know that these square boxes are 0, 1, 2, 3. The number is 0, 1, 2, 3. So what are the minterms, like what are the minterms that output having logic 1, its corresponding minterms. 0, 1 is the combination, its corresponding output is high. 1, 0 combination minterm, its corresponding high. So we can consider those minterms. 0, 1, 0, x direction first row, second column, you can make one logic one, and 1 0 means one in the square box, second row, first column. And now we can apply the Kirchhoff K-map rules for the carry. Also, you can take the K-map x, y. This is carry, this is sum K-map, this is carry K-map. Each column having its own Karnaugh map. 0, 1, 0, 1, only 1, 1 is there, its corresponding output is high, remaining will be 0. So now next step is check with is there any all 1s in the square boxes. If it is not there, then 2 1s are there. If it is not there, single 1. So no 4 1s, no pair. So directly this individually we can conclude. And here it is only 1. So we can make one circle. How can we write the horizontally which row it is? Second row, 1 means x. So sum is equal to, in horizontally it is x because of x under 1. Then vertically 0. So x, y bar. And this circle for minimized function is x row, x is equal to 0 row, x bar means x bar, y is equal to 1 means y. So actually, no further simplification, but directly we can, whatever the minterms are there in the square box, same minterms come in the sum output. See also. So in second row, second column, only x and y is the output. No reduction. But for the sake of explanation, I'll take this K map, how to minimize the function, how to take the Boolean function. In the fourth step, we can take the truth table. In the fifth step, we can simplify the Boolean function. And then sixth one, we can draw the logic diagram. Draw the logic diagram for its corresponding Boolean function x bar y bar c is equal to xy. So x bar y bar plus xy bar plus x bar y is the SOP Boolean function. It requires two AND gates, one OR gate. When we represent with the complement variable as it is. So x y bar, first x y bar, if take the AND gate, it is under representation x y bar. X is one input, y bar is the another input. And x bar y, this is x bar y represented by another AND gate. These two AND gates are connected with a simple OR gate. You can connect the sum. And carry directly require only one AND gate because x and y output you will get x y. We'll get someone to carry. Otherwise, we in a previous lectures we have already studied the x y bar plus x bar y plus x y bar is look like a XOR gate operation. So directly we can take x y input to take the XOR gate. It perform the x a bar b plus a b bar like x bar y x y bar, and same x y we can take. Same x, y can take with AND gate, you will get sum, carry, sum AND carry. Otherwise, we can also represent with sum can be represented with C plus x bar y bar. So, this sum can be represented, C means xy. So, xy plus x bar y bar whole bar. So, when we expanding the De Morgan's law, xy bar dot x bar y bar whole bar. So when we expanding, we will get a xy plus x bar y bar, which represents the, so we can apply this x bar plus y bar into x plus y. When we multiplying these two, so it is like a distribution or transposition property. So x into x 0, y into y 0, only x into x bar into y plus x y bar only possibilities to come. So finally, XR operation. But we can utilize, if you write this equation into this one, we can utilize this C plus x y bar whole bar as a sum. X y is the C. So same C can be utilized. So utilization of same gates for the sum and carry in this logic gates. Full adder. So in this way we can follow those steps, define the problem, assign the identify the number of inputs and outputs, assign the variables to the inputs and outputs, and create the truth table, apply the k-map to minimize the boolean function, and then draw the logic diagram. Same things we can apply for full adder. A full adder definition is a full adder is a combination circuit which performs the arithmetic sum of three input bits. Sometimes it requires three inputs A, B, 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1. If you can add these 1 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 1 0 and 1 1 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 1 0 1, here it is 3 bits. 2 One bit is A, one bit is B, another bit is carry from previous bits. So in odd, sometimes it required to add three numbers, not only two numbers. So in this case, after fail to adding up these three numbers, so we can go with the full adder. Full adder perform the summing of 3 bits. That is the problem statement. Define the input and outputs. So in order to add 3 bits, it requires 3 variables, 3 inputs. So inputs are 3. So in the output, sum and carry, so 2 outputs. Define the input and output notation. Inputs are x, y, z. Outputs are sum and carry. This is the truth table. X, y, z is the truth table. Sum and carry is the sum and carry are the output columns. X, y, z is the input combination, input column. So here it is. We can have 3 variables in the input. That means it provides 2 power 3 combinations at the input side. What are those 2 power 3 combinations? 0 0 0 to 1 1. And its corresponding sum and carry output result in the output column in the truth table. So if you check this sum and carry, 0 plus 0 plus 0 will get 0, carry 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 1, sum is 1, carry 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. Sum 1, carry 0. And 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 0, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 1, 0. 0, sum 0, carry 1. 1 0 1 double 0, 1 plus 0 1, 1 plus 0 1, so sum 1, carry 0. In this way, so 1 means 1 plus 1 1, 1 plus 1 means 1 0 0, carry 0, sum carry 1. 0 sum, 2 1s are there, 0 sum carry 1. If 3 1s are there, sum 1 carry 1. So likewise we can calculate. If you see this entire things, so in this case 1 1 2 4 7, its corresponding combinations, the output sum will be high. And 3 3567. It's corresponding input combinations only, the output will be high. So find out the Boolean function from the K-map. If it is three variable, we can take the three variable K-map, two rows under four columns, x in horizontal direction, y, z in x column wise, it is for sum K-map. You know that it is 0 curve column, 0 1 row, 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0. We know that its numbers, it is in square box number 0 1 3 2 4 5 7 6. What are the corresponding outputs? Logic 1. What is the output column? Yes, those logic 1s are placed in the corresponding minterms. 0 0 1. Place 1, logic 1, 0, 1, 0, place 1 in the 2, and 1, double 0, 4, and 7. If you check this one, there is no 8 ones, and there will be no 4 ones, quad, adjacency, and pair also not there. So, directly, you can create individual one. There is no horizontally adjacent, there is no vertically adjacent ones in the corresponding numbers. So sum is always in this case. This case also we can find one special thing. These are all essential prime implicants because no one single minterm is combined with other minterms. So they are called essential prime implicant. And take the corresponding Boolean function. There will be no minimized literals. Directly we can take the minterms, its corresponding combination. So this one is one means x bar, y bar, z. Two means x bar, y, z bar. Plus four means x, y bar, z bar. Seven means x, y, z. So directly we can take the minterms for some carry. What is carry? If you take the carry K map, x, y, z. So 0, 1 row, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. What are the logic ones? Here it is logic 1 means 3. 0 row, 1 1 column means 0 double 1 means 3. 5 7 5 6 7. It is 5 6 7. How can we make the K map adjacency boxes? Is there any 8 ones? No 8 ones. Is there any 4 ones? No 4 ones. So, you know, if I am covering this one, if I am minimizing this one, only possible is pair. Then how many number of ones are left? Two ones are there, this one and this one. In order to cover this one, only one way of possibility, this one to make pair. In order to cover this one, only one possibility is pair. So there are three pairs, so we can find out the carry expression. Let us take this one. Which row? Second row. X is equal to 1 row means x is equal to 1. And what are the columns cover? What are the columns? Two columns are covered here. This one, 0, 1 and 1, 1. Which one is common variable, common logic value? 0, 1 and 1, 1. 1 is the logic, common. That means Z, X, Z. It is over. Next, this one. Same X, 1, 1 and 1, 0 common value, Y is common. And this vertically, this one, this box, this pair. Horizontally, 0, x is equal to 0 and 1 are cancelled together. Only we can consider 1, 1. That means y, z. So, this is the expression for sum and carry. Now, we can simplify the Boolean function. And then, those Boolean functions are from the K-map. S is equal to x bar, y bar, z, x bar, y, z bar, x, y bar, z bar plus x, y. Carry is equal to x, y plus x, z plus y, z. So this can be implemented. This is the simplified Boolean function. this simplified Boolean function can be implemented with the help of logic gates. So in this case, this is actually this is one AND gate 2, 1, 3, 4 AND gates are combined to one OR gates. Here is also, these are the AND gates. These AND gates are combined with a single OR gate. In this way, we can draw the logic diagram. We are considering complemented variable as it is. Directly, we can take the complemented variable X bar, Y bar, Z. This is 3 input to AND gate. Another minterm AND gate. 3 input AND gates. These are connected with the 4 input OR gate. Okay. 4 input OR gate. It is called S. XY, YZ, XZ of these 3 AND gates are connected with a simple OR gate. You will get C. And also we can draw this expression. If you see this sum means actually the expression sum can be represented with Z XR, X XR Y. You can take this associate law. Z XR, X XR Y. This X XR Y is the first XR gate. This output is XR with the Z input. Then we can draw the diagram. So, because if you expanding this one, so first you expanding this X or X operation. For example, it is a, this one is some letter A. Z XR A means Z bar A plus Z A bar. That is the expression for XR gate. And a substitute whatever the A we can consider. X bar Y plus X Y bar. If you substitute this one, it is a Z bar, it is A, it is Z, it is A bar. When we can performing the this complement we can take as an XNOR gate. Then this one is substituting the Z bar into this expression, you will get the sum expression. So sum expression can also be represented with two XR gates, Z XR, X XR Y. For example, this is X XR Y, XR gate. This output XXRY combined with Z input. So Z XR XXRY will get the sum. And carry, the carry term can be written as Z XXRY, Z into XXRY plus XY. So we can reuse this one. One XR gate we can reuse and multiply with Z and then we add with XY. So how can we utilize? So here it is XY, one term, we will get XY. This XY is ORed with which one? Z into XR gate. We have already Z XR gate. So take that XR output, X XR Y from this one. Take that one is one input and Z is the another input. So we can combine it together to give the R gate, you will get C. Entire C. So in this way, this can be written as, this can be represented in simple way. So we know that half adder from the direct one XR gate and AND gate, we can take that this is a one half adder box. And this is also one another half adder box. Off adder, and one XR gate, or like R gate. So in order to get the full adder, 3 inputs, X, Y, Z, sum, carry. Simply we can connect with one off adder, another off adder, plus R gate. This is sum. We can draw this one. Off adder output is giving to the second off adder. Its output is connected to sum. and this output, this half adder output connected with the OR gate, you will get half adder, two half adder plus one OR gate, two half adder plus OR gate is called full adder. So we can also design in this way. Next, full subtractor. We know that subtractor 0 minus 0 will get a difference and borrow in the outputs. 0 0 0 difference 0 borrow 0 0 1 difference. If you want to difference 0 1, we require borrow, take the borrow. 1 0 minus 1 means 1 0 its equivalent number, decimal number is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So we need one borrow, take borrow, and 2 minus 1 means 1. 1 0 subtraction of 1 minus 0 means 1, no borrow. 1 1 difference 0, borrow 0. Likewise, we use those rules, we can create this truth table. 0 0 0 triple 0, 0 minus 0, and then the result minus 0, 0 0. 0 0 minus 0 0, 0 minus 1, borrow, take the borrow, and then difference is 1. Likewise, we can create this table. Once we can create the table, we can, with the help of kmap, we can find the borrow and difference equation. This is full subtractor. For this one, 1, 2, 3, 7. 1 2 3 7 1 2 3 7. So how can we make? No way. In order to cover this one, we need to pair. In order to cover this one, we need to create pair. In order to cover this one, pair. Three pairs means definitely borrow require 3 billion functions, x bar y, x bar z plus y z. And D, in order to get D, so logic 1, like minterm 1, minterm 2, 4, 7. X, Y, Z. 1, 2, 1, 2, 4, 7, 4, 7. Again, single circles. If it is single circles, same output, whatever you got in from the half full adder. So we will get same output. So logic diagram for this one is same as we drawn in the full adder. We will get the same diagram. But in this case, the three AND gates, one OR gate. But complement inputs variable x bar, x bar z. Next, magnitude comparator. In order to compare only two bits, for example, if single bit comparator. If it is 0, A 0, B 0, then we can output call it as equal. A is 0, B is 1, A less than B, A equal B. These are the output. So 1 0, we can use A greater than B. We can use A greater than B. So this is single comparator, single bit comparator. If you want to perform the 4 bit comparator, which is called magnitude comparator. So in order to perform the 4 bit comparator, suppose A represented with A3. A2, A1, B, B3, B2, B1, A0, B0. These are the 4 bits, A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3. How can we compare these 4 kind of 4 bits by using magnitude comparator? Suppose both A, entire A bits, and both entire B bits are same. A bits, 4 A bits are zeros, 4 zeros, 4 B bits are 4 zeros, then they are equal. So we can consider that A is equal to B. Then only, if all bits are same, either in zeros or ones, then we can represent it with A is equal to B. So that can be represented by a variable x I, where I is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. So in this case, we can return as A B plus A bar B bar, we can represent it with I. If you substitute I is equal to 0, so this one, these two, if A 0, B 0, both are 0, it is like an expression for XNOR gate, A B plus A bar B bar. If you substitute I is equal to 0, A naught B naught plus A naught bar B naught bar, that expression represents XNOR. XNOR gate always, the utility of XNOR gate is, it passes the same equal number of bits. If same number of input bits are there, the logic output is 1. If opposite inputs are there, logic output is 0. So in this case, if both inputs here A0, B0 are same, how can we get this one, this thing, whether it is they are equal or not, by checking with the help of XNOR gate. So A0, B0 connected with XNOR, A1, B1 connected with 2 input XNOR, A2, B2, A3, B3. So generally we can consider as XI is equal to AI, BI plus A bar, BI bar. If all are, I is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, if all our bits are same, then XI will be 1. This one can be represented with, if substitute X1, XI, X0 is equal to 1. By implement with this XNOR gates, and then these are entirely connected to AND gates, then we can define that if I is equal to 0 substitute this first bit, check this first bit, you will get xi is equal to 1, and x0 is equal to 1, x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 1, x3 is equal to 1. So those, comparing those 4 bits all are equal, then xi is equal to 1. This can be connected to AND gates. Xi is equal to x3, x2, x1, x0. So if x0, x1, x2, x3 are all 1, so AND operation xi is equal to 1, that xi represents that A equal to B. Similarly, if A greater than B, A less than B can be identified with the help of, first check the MSB bit. A3, A2, A1, A0, B3, B2, B1, B0. If this bit is equal, for example, unequal, A 1 triple 0, 0 triple 1. If this bit is high, MSB bit having more weightage, this one, this is logic 1, so automatically this first number is greater, A greater than B. So if A3 greater than B, if A3 bit is 1, bit compared with B3, the number is above A greater than B. A greater than B is the logic, that logic corresponding pin is logic high. Suppose if both are equal, if it is, for example, this one is 0, this one is 1 in the MSB bit, then we can decide that A is less than B. But what happen if both are equal, if MSB bit both are equal, if this MSB bit is both are equal, then check with the next one. Again, this 0, this one means A less than B. This one, A is 1, B 0 means A greater than B. So likewise, we can continuously check MSB bit. If both are equal, then check with the other one. That can be mathematically represented with, if A3, B3 bar means A3 1, B3 0. When A3 1, MSB bit A is 1, B3 0, automatically A is greater than B. With irrespective of this combination, we can directly consider that this bit is, based on this bit, we can take it A greater than B. The same way, A3 bar B3, if A3 is 0, B3 is 1, we can directly say that A less than B. Suppose if, that is one condition. Suppose this is not entirely complete case. This is one case only. Suppose A3, B3 both are same. If both are same, this bit is 0, then it depends on other one. So both are same, that means X3, if both are same, X3 will get 1, because X3 nothing but A3 and B3 XNR operation. So X3, if it means that both are MS bits are same, then multiplied with A2 and B2 bar. A2 means uncomplemented, means that is high. So suppose again this one also both are same, second bit also, second A2 B2 also same, then check with this next one, X3, X2 are same, then check with A1 B1 bar. If both three bits are same, then last, based on last bit, we can compare it. Again 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1 is like 1 0, that means these three bits are same. So check with only last LSB bit. This is 1, this is 0, means this is the logic high, like greater. So A greater than B. So by considering all the possibilities, we can implement the function, Boolean function. Similarly, A less than B. So if it is A3 bar B3, means A3 bar means 0. So always A less than B. Suppose these are two equal in this second case. That means X3 multiplied by, if these two are equal, then A2 bar B2. Likewise, you can check until the last one. We can consider that A less than B by following this Boolean function. The logic, its logic corresponding logic diagram for A equal B. So A equal B is nothing but XNOR operation. Like X3, this is entire thing is XNOR. If both are same inputs, you will get X3 1, X2 1, X1 1, X0 1. So this is repeated for XNOR gates. Check with XNOR gates. Okay. Finally, if you check it, you will get XNOR operation. So all are combined with logic 1. If all are logic high because of XNOR gates, same inputs, logic 1. All logic 1s connected to AND gate, you will get A equal B high. Otherwise, it fail any case. Otherwise, you will get 0. Similarly, A greater than B. In the A greater than B, which is connected to this one, A3, B3 bar. First one, A3, B3 bar. This is the case. A3, B3 bar. That is AND operation. It will connect it to direct. Next case is this one. That can be connected with this one. Next, this one. Four terms. Here it is, four terms are there. You will get four terms are connected with the OR gate. So successfully, each term is any one term, logic 1, will get A greater than B1, otherwise 0. Suppose I am getting the output A less than B0, A greater than B1, A equal B0. At a time, only one output is high in the comparator, magnitude comparator. This means A greater than B out is the compare with, in the comparison, A greater than B. 0, 0, 1, both are equal. A and B are equal. 100, 100, A less than B. These three possibilities in the output. So we can make the truth table also by giving four inputs, and then you will get three outputs, A equal B, A greater than B, A less than B. So with the help of magnitude, we can compare at a time four bits. A 4 bits, B 4 bits. We can compare and we will give the output, whether it is A equal B, A greater than B, A less than B. So this is what about a combinational circuit. In the combinational circuits, adder, subtractor and comparator. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.